Okay, you don't know. Okay, you can just pretend you understand. Just laugh the same time that they are. So. Okay, my name is Anton Tymoshenko. I'm a comedian from Kyiv, Ukraine, and Ukraine is the best place to be a comedian now because your career can rise very high. For example, if you're a good comedian in USA, you can have a late night show. If you're a good comedian in Ukraine, you can destroy Russia. That's, for example, that's much more interesting than Jimmy Fallon's late night show. I'm not sure Jimmy Fallon can handle with Russia. Jimmy Kimmel, Stephen Colbert, probably. Jimmy Fallon can destroy Russia only in a lip sync battle. You don't get it. That's a joke for Americans, that's fine, because. Because they have money and we don't, that's why I try. I make this video, try to collect some money from the world to help my country in this war. And this is such a strange feeling. Last 10 years of my life, I was raising money to have a flat in Kyiv. Now I'm raising money to win a war! That's a little bit more difficult. But I'm not sure what more difficult, because flats in Kyiv were expensive. I hope now they'll give me a discount. My colleague, Volodymyr Zelensky, he is performing now all over the world, have some specials in different parliaments. And he was also at the Grammys, that's nice, but he was not invited to the Oscar. Maybe good, because as I know, these Oscars comedians were beaten in the face. As I remember. But I would like to see how Will Smith tried to get Zelensky. That's Russia can... Russia can beat him. I don't think Will Smith has a chance because I'm a legend. This is Zelensky stuff now. Not your Will Smith. No. Yeah, this is our comedy cellar in Ukraine. Look like this. Like, all my country in cellar now, to tell the truth. Because of bombing and rockets, all this stuff. So it's really easy to find audience for stand-up, because... you just come and people hear. and they can't go out because of virus sirens, so you can tell bullshit. Like I do in Ukrainian when I... make my stand-up. One of the benefits of living near Russia is that you always live in a moment, you know? Always live in a moment, because we might have only a moment to live in Ukraine. People around the world try to find this way how to live in a moment. They try this mindfulness meditation, fly to Thailand or to Bali. Stop, just come to Ukraine. Russia helps you much more faster than deep breathing exercises like that. Anton, how do you become so enlightened? It's yoga? No, it's Russian bombs. the special course in Kharkiv. Okay, I feel so alive. Live each day as if it was your last, that Steve Jobs said. He had cancer, Ukraine has Russia. That's pretty much the same. I know that world loves Ukraine, I feel it. My favorite when countries try to light up buildings with our national colors, like the Eiffel Tower was. And this is so brave because Russia can accidentally bomb it, like... oh, it's not Ukraine, sorry! Who are you? France? Okay, we'll bomb you later, that's fine. Next in the schedule. I like France, but I don't really understand how Emmanuel Macron can look more tired than people from Mariupol. That's a huge talent, Emmanuel. We already collect some food and money from Chernihiv to you, just hang on. We will help you soon, as much as we can. The funniest country in Europe is Germany. Because when we ask for weapons, Germany says, we don't have enough weapon to share. Oh, come on, Germany. Come on, my grandmother said you have a lot of. And, or you can create it very quickly. She remembered that. Что, как вообще нормально вам слушать английскую? This is not so difficult. I can do it. Boris Johnson's come to Ukraine. I can go to UK if you need. Like, our main comedian are a little bit busy now, so you can take me. I give you a couple of jokes about Ukraine. Let's talk about sanctions. Sanctions. They always announced more sanctions. They always have more sanctions. And I just don't understand why they just don't use all sanctions like right now. Why do we always need to ask West and West answer us like it's internet provider? Like, yes, Ukraine, if you want to get new package of sanctions, please upload more photos of dead people from Bucha, please. I'm sorry, you don't have enough dead children to get new package of sanctions, so just try later or use our old package. Це ще не пиздец. Now we'll be пиздец, because I noticed that the speed of sanctions is about 2 raped children a day. Yeah, the West act the sanctions with the speed of 2 raped Ukrainian children a day. This is too slow. This is speed of Michael Jackson. So you need to be faster. Yeah, this is a rough joke, rough times, rough jokes. Sorry about that. It's not so rough as a bump on your head, for example. Just try it. You need to know that Ukraine will never surrender. And I have an example how much we unite. I have a friend. She was very depressed before war. And I met her like a couple of weeks ago and asked how it feels now. Apparently difficult. And she said she even thought about suicide before war. And now she said, no, I feel much more better. I ask why. She said, because now I don't think about suicide. I'm thinking about how to kill Russians. And, thank you, Putin. You saved my friend. For me, this is the best example how Ukrainians unite against Russia, because people ready to delay suicide. She literally moved her deadline to see Putin's deadline first. That's... And the punchline of the story that she is from Russia. She was born in Russia and she moved to Ukraine like, I don't know, 5 or 6 years ago. And I said to her, Yulia, she's named Yulia. Yulia, you're so lucky. You can kill always at least one Russian, yourself. She approved the joke, so, because she's cool. I think after war, she can change her mind to kill herself because she have already seen Russian soldiers' lives. You need to know that Russians always looting a lot of stuff from Ukraine, like TVs, cars, and like steal money, food, all this stuff. We have photos where you can see that Russian soldiers steal a doghouse. Yeah, there is a man in Russian army who decided to steal doghouse instead of kill himself. So. If he continues to live, probably in this doghouse. Why she has to go? She has to stay too. Yeah, so I have bad news for Putin. Ukrainians now have something to live for. That's your death. Yeah. A couple of words about Russian propaganda. Russian propaganda is so stupid. Putin does all his crimes like there is no internet in the world, you know. And anti-vax statesmen is like a diploma in physics compared to Russian propaganda. You just can't read the news from Russia seriously because they always have a punchline. Like, for example, a typical title, Ukraine has biological weapon. Birds, chickens, and bats who carries infections when they fly. And all of this finance from the USA. Thank you, USA. Now I can always go to KFC in Kiev and buy some biological bucket. Hazardous chicken. What next? Russia will say, there are teenage mutants ninja turtles in the Ukrainian army. They were born in Chernobyl. Look at Michelangelo and Leonardo together. It's Ukrainian flag. Russia came to Ukraine to fight fascism. But did you see Russian soldiers and army, this letter V, letter Z, their messages like Ukraine is not a country, Ukrainians are not a nation. What was the plan? To catch fascists, you need to think like fascists. Maybe become fascists. If Russia wants to destroy fascism, they can just kill themselves. This is the nice up. Famous fascists do this stuff, so did this stuff. So just try. You need to know only one fact about Russia to understand it. They have a dead man, Lenin, who created this USSR stuff. They embalmed him like a pharaoh, like with Mary Kay cosmetics probably. And he is laying in a museum, and children from Russian schools go to this museum to see this dead man and never sleep, I suppose, then. Why they do this stuff with Lenin? There is only two reasons to have this look alive Lenin for Russia. First reason, they would like to have alive USSR, or it's just very expensive sex doll, you know. And Putin looks like a man who can fuck the old guy in basement. Don't you agree with that fact? So you really think this country can be a member of United Nations? A couple of words about United Nations. Oh, we love United Nations in Ukraine. Why do we spend money on it? Because it's not working. In fact, Russia unites countries much faster than United Nations, using weapon and all this stuff. It works a little bit better. We can fire all the guys from United Nations and just replace them with my mom, because she also always concerned about everything in the world, and she can do anything with this shit. She also can be concerned that she's concerned. This is new level. Like when she say, oh, I feel so concerned that I start to concerned about effect on my mental health. Is it concerning? I don't know, mom. United Nations become a meme in Ukraine because a lot of Ukrainians try to help Ukrainian army, and we always feel we did not enough to help. And when ordinary Ukrainian feel he's useless, we just say, don't worry, just don't forget that United Nations exists. One of the main problems that world can stop buying oil and gas from Russia, this is the main problem with sanctions, they continue to buy this oil and gas. And this situation says so much about our world and our future, because even if we forget about the war, like for a second, all people understand that we need to reduce the use of oil and gas to save our planet. But we continue to buy this stuff even when thousands of people are dying. Do you really believe we will change or save environment some days? I'm sure when people start dying from global warming, world be like, okay, we imposing our sanctions against the sun. Now sun cannot buy iPhone. And, if sun will not stop warming up the planet, we will deploy NATO troops on Mars. So think about that, sun. Tell the truth, I'm a big fan of global warming. I'm a big fan of global warming because it will kill Russian oil business. And when temperature goes up, Putin will sweat first in this situation. And this is Nord Stream 2 become just a slide in huge water park. If you're gonna get quickly from Russia to Germany. До свидания! Guten Abend, ich bin groß, du bist klein. Wir sind lustig, das ist fein. Need weapons, Germany. Not the right. And the world afraid of nuclear war, everybody afraid of nuclear war from Russia, but it has already started. Just look at the Mariupol. There is no buildings in Mariupol. Chernobyl looks a little bit better than Mariupol now. because of Russia. That's the problem. And I think that Russia is more dangerous than nuclear weapon, because nuclear weapon works with some kind of laws, like chemical laws and physical laws. There are no laws in Russia. All kinds of laws not working in Russia. So scientists know a lot of stuff about uranium behavior. What do they know about Putin's behavior? Nobody can predict this stuff. It's more safe to have a walk with uranium than Putin, because you never know how Putin is gonna kill you. To understand how bad is Putin, you need to know that all the world unites against Russia to help Ukraine, the Switzerland, ISIS, like the Pope, and even the Satanist temple. Satanic temple. Satanic temple, this is the most popular and famous Satanist organization in the world, and they posit that they stand with Ukraine. To make it clear, the Pope and Satan become allies against Russia. How much Putin is bad. Now we need to be careful in Ukraine, like we have some help from abroad. Oh, guys, we have some help from abroad, medicine, food. Oh, thanks God. No, no, that's from Satan. Oh, thanks Satan? Thank you. Thanks a lot. I know maybe while watching this video you think, war far away from me. I can always run away to Australia. That's comforting, but false because it's too expensive, Australia. Tickets to Sydney. It falls because our planet is an ellipsoid, it's a circle. So if you start to run from one point, someday you will get the place you start. So I ask you to help Ukraine, to give donates, and remember that Ukraine starts with you. Thank you.